bell. Here comes the gentleman's top. Did they talk at the driver's meeting about the gentleman's top? Because it looks like they really, really popped down the tops for the gentleman's top here. Not quite as aggressive as they used to be. But here they come. The Cadillac does a hit on that Imperial. And boy, I tell you, that's a little bumper. Looks like it's about 4 feet off the ground compared to the other vehicles. Here we come. Got a station wagon. This one's doing notoriously. Station wagons work out rather well in a demolition derby. Could be the extra strength of the frame or perhaps the way the body is situated, but station wagons normally do well. It's the extra weight, because if your family is sitting there right behind you, telling you what to do, it's not very driving. But it looks like somebody's mother-in-law sitting in the back of the car. Yeah, the Cadillac's in there doing a couple nice hits. Number 54, Brad Jones.
Good going, Brad. He's got a hit on
Joe Crow, and I think he plans on staying to the end.
Keep it up, hit him again.
Where there's going to be some big-time action, because it looks pretty calm going right now. See the back of the Cadillac sinking underneath that Imperial, which, oh, by the way, didn't move when it got hit. That little bit of moisture, certainly the traction has changed, so they've got to change their driving slightly. Now, number 99, Jeremy, I see some of those bodies. He's hung up over there. Is that what the problem with 99, or is there car problems? Is he out already?
I think he's called on preferred towing, if I'm not mistaken.
Well, he could phone Scott's Auto Records, because they're right on site here, and I believe they're waiting for the demolition cars to end. Scott's got a little deal with these guys.
Yes, they've just dropped off, and they are prepared to buy the cars at the end of the road. Up there at the north, and it's the yellow and black stuff. And a free hat with every person.
Right now, I don't know if they're for us or not, but they're beautiful, beautiful hats. Scott's Auto Records, a real classy outfit. Howie's one of the sponsors here at the Freaky Care Demolition Derby. Helps the drivers and crew out. Again, let's look what's going on. Looks like Joe Crow's stuck. Looks like 42 is still moving, still doing some hitting.
Joe's spinning, so he's locked.
Amazing part about number 42 is that he's not in his heat, so it must be another number.
Whoa, we got some work to do. Look at that front back end folder.
47 for that.
We got some work to do.
47?
You pull out with the jeep?
One with a white door.
We're going to have to try.
Okay.
But I don't know if
47 against the far side right now.
I like the big smiley face on the station wagon number 69.
Oh, SpongeBob?
SpongeBob, that's what it is. I knew I recognized that yellow. You should get SpongeBob and Barbie together.
Look at the scale on that.
Oh, I see SpongeBob. I'm looking for SquarePants.
It's even got a tow chain there on the front.
Again, that Cadillac back end is just crinkled in. That's a big hit on him, but still moving well. Number 54, Brad Jones, still doing the job.
Lower up, Brad.
SpongeBob still looks like it's going.
It died.
And four competitors still moving.
47 is a short performance. I hope that's not anything by what's on the door.
I believe that's one of Preston's gold limousines that he's driving right now, one of the solo ones.
Well, look at the wagon, Crowley. We've got two to fit. It's going
to be a lot easier to put the luggage on now.
Much easier. And you can keep an eye on it at the same time. Well, the Imperial fires up and crashes. That's a big, big hit. Crushes. I mean, crushes the station wagon. SpongeBob, but look at, he's still got gears going. He's still got action. Little luck for the spectators. Thank you, Joe. Justine's Limousine sponsored car, 47, still doing a great job. Jason Dixon, the driver, number 47, still in there. Looks like it's him and Joe Crow doing battle right now.
Looks like somebody did an oil change over there on the 1 block, Mike.